Hey everybody and welcome. Today I'm coming at you from Scottsdale, Arizona. I'm here to answer a question that I've had for almost two decades. What the heck is Tom's Thumb? For those of you that live here, you've probably heard of it. You probably have seen it on the other side of the mountains, maybe commuting on your way to work, driving around Scottsdale. Well, I'm here to see what it's like up close and personal. And if you've ever wondered that yourself, stick around and let's go check it out. All right, I just arrived here at the trailhead for Tom's Thumb Trail. And you can see it's more people than I would have thought for a July day in Arizona in the summer. Kind of pleased to see a selection of vehicles because maybe that will lessen the chance that someone will break into my car since there are more people here, but I was hoping for less. So I came here in the afternoon to avoid crowds. So I wouldn't call this a crowd, but still more people than I would have thought. And very doubtful that we're gonna run into this today in the middle of the day because they don't like to come out in the middle of the day, but yeah, you got rattlesnakes out here. So you always wanna be wary of that. Lots of really amazing information about the geology of this area. They're talking about Tom's Thumb, which is made of granite, so it's a granite monolith. And they've got these little things to line up your view. One, for Tom's Thumb, so let's see here. If we could see Mr. Tom's Thumb, look at that. You see it? That's our destination today, way up there. All right, I am ready to do this. Been wanting to do this for a very long time and I have no idea why the heck I haven't. So yeah, I think let's just get this party started. So some basic stats about this trail. All trail says it's 4 miles long out and back, so up to the top, back the way we came. 1,200 feet, a little bit more than that in elevation gain. So certainly not the toughest thing I've ever done by far. The sign, interestingly, down there at the trailhead says it's 2.2 miles to the top, which means it's more like closer to 4.5 miles round trip. So whatever, to me that's pretty negligible. Already the views are fantastic, especially facing east towards Four Peaks. I suspect once we get to the top, we'll be able to see Scottsdale and Phoenix from the other side. So excited to see what that view's like. So also lots of educational signs about the plants of the area. So if you're new to the Sonoran Desert and want to learn what the plants are, I always love when places do stuff like this. Always a nice touch. And I'll be for the first to tell you, I'm still learning and I've lived here almost 20 years now. I certainly don't know what every single plant is. I know the popular ones, the cacti and things like that, but yeah, some of the leafier ones, still learning. And some beautiful prickly pear. I mean, these aren't as vibrant as a lot of the other ones, the fruit that you see on them. But these are some of my favorite cacti here in the Sonoran Desert, especially when they've got the fruit on them. Oftentimes you'll see them much more vibrant red hues, but these are still pretty. I don't think this is the exact same type of cholla that we see every time. These look a little bit different, more bulbous on the inside. I've experienced it, and Amy can certainly tell you from recent experience, all these thorny things in the desert, even in our backyard. Every once in a while, one of us will be walking around the yard doing yard work or whatever, wearing sneakers with rubber sole shoes, and you'll just catch one of these like really strong spines that'll go through your shoe and into your foot. No joke. I don't think either one of us haven't had a situation where we had to go see a doctor or go to urgent care or anything, but man, is that painful. As we approach the base of this mountain here. Didn't look that steep from far off, but the closer I get, that's looking ever higher up on that mountainside. We're gonna get it done, don't you worry, but yeah, we got some climbing to do today. I only learned this morning from some quick internet-based research, where did Tom Thumb get its name? I figured it was something from like the 1800s, the Old West, the pioneer days. Apparently it's not. Apparently it's named after a guy named Tom that hiked up to the top of this thing about 40 years ago, I think is what it said. So what is that? Like the late 1970s, early 80s, I'm guessing. So yeah, it's not some named after some pioneer or something like that. Just the dude that went up there for the first time, apparently. A quick check-in. This is very handy. We have 1.7 miles to go to get to the top. Just you wait, old Tom Thumb. I'm a-coming for you. Started the climb suddenly here. I can feel my legs. Haven't been using them properly. So, definitely got the heavy breathing going on. Certainly a testament to how easy it is to lose it if you're not careful. Especially once you hit middle age. Whew. So I'm here at Harris's Hawk Vista. Beautiful overview of the surrounding area. Some lucky son of a gun got a beautiful house out here in the middle of the desert. The only thing that kind of sucks, and I noticed this coming in, you could see a lot of construction sites, probably building new homes over there, over there. Can we just not leave some of the land alone here in Arizona? Come on. Here's a quick progress check-in. You can see the parking lot and that covered facility where the restrooms were where I started. Really good view. We're coming up high enough to see Four Peaks again. Absolutely stunning view of that. Just down to water, staying hydrated. I'm feeling the heat actually, even though it's in the 90s. It's affecting me a little bit heavier today. You can see, still got a ways to go. According to a sign over here, we have 1.4 miles to go, which means we are almost halfway there, but not quite. So I'm at a nice little overlook, drinking some water, getting closer, but still got a ways to go. Pretty elusive, that Tom's Thumb, I'd say. You know, a thought that just occurred to me. I don't recall seeing a single saguaro cactus today here, and we're in the Sonoran Desert. There's a lone one down there. And that's really weird, actually, you know, for being out here in the desert, because like right on the other side of this, you'll see hundreds of them. And who would have known there was such a wonderland of rocks back here? Rock climbing, all sorts of recreational activities here, right behind the McDowells. This might now be my favorite trail in the Phoenix area. And certainly a really good one, I think, for fitness. A lot of people trail running here, and I think this is a good one because you can see the trail has been very clear, free of obstructions. And another check-in point, 0.8 miles to go. Still making progress, but boy, does it feel like I came further than that. And yeah, that shot you saw of me, kind of walking from in a distance down this trail here. The camera was way up on that hill. I walked to this point and had to go back and get the camera. So I'm doing double duty here. Just trying to show you the commitment I have to the Cactus Atlas. We take it seriously around here. So less than a half mile ago, and I came across this gem, this shade, sweet, sweet shade. This spot in the shade, oh my God. This was a godsend, really. I needed this. Nice comfortable seat on the rocks here too. Holy moly. I don't think I'm far, but yeah, this is stretching me to my limits today. All right, I'm heading out again, leaving my nice little shady spot. Could hit it on the way back. Yeah, I wanna get up there because I'm gonna try to get there before other people show up. I think I'm the only one up on the mountain now. And now we came up and over the McDowells and we're looking off towards Phoenix now. In North Scottsdale, I think, is that not Piestewa Peak? Maybe Camelback, I can't tell exactly. It's interesting how wide these mountains are though, like the depth to them. In my mind, I just pictured like really steep mountains that you would go over really quick, but it's really a sequence of like really tall hills and mountains that kind of roll. So crossing them has been quite a chore. Ironically, the higher up I go, the more shade there is. Not complaining though. Not complaining in the slightest. Ladies and gentlemen, I give you Tom's thumb. More like Tom's shade. For me personally, this is an epic moment. You don't understand how long I pondered this rock monolith. All these years, and here I am, face to face with Tom's thumb. I am leaning up against Tom's thumb. The angle is perfect for leaning. So they do advertise the trail and warn you that it's very exposed and no shade. And that's true most of the time, but clearly there is a reward waiting for you at the top depending on the time of day and the angle of the sun, of course. Exquisite, righteous shade. Look at this too. I'm afraid to go in here almost if that thing fell. Look at all these little caves, like little areas of shade. They're very clear. I don't know if there are any critters are in here, but all within view of Mr. Tom's thumb. All right, so Tom's thumb. I touched it. I made the equivalent of snow angels on it and rubbed my sweat all over it. I conquered it. Another one to mark off the list. I got you, Tom's thumb. I got you. And that raven agrees. All right, Tom's thumb, I will see you later. Nice to make your acquaintance finally though. Now I gotta walk back. I'm only halfway done with the hike today, if you can believe that. Oh my God.
All right, turning around, getting one more look at Tom's Thumb before heading on back down, drinking in the view.
You know, I like trails like this that have like a prize at the end, something unique to see. So that's why this trail I think is pretty cool. Tom's Thumb is awesome. Definitely a unique sight here in the Phoenix area. All right, so here's the deal, I'm back. That destroyed me. Holy moly. Trying to analyze what happened here. So I made it to the top. I feel awesome about that. I've checked that off my list. But I've never struggled with a hike like that in my entire life. And I did have to pee recently, and I think part of the reason is despite thinking that I was hydrated enough and had enough water, it's clear that I didn't, based on the color of my urine, not to be gross, but just being factual. I brought enough water with me, and I still have water left. I wasn't wanting of water. I think the key is that I didn't drink enough before I came here, and I thought I did, but I think that's part of it. I think the other part of it is I'm older now, and each time I just let months go by and I don't do anything to really maintain my fitness, today was a wake-up call. My first real wake-up call, I think. I really think I recognize the importance of trying to stay fit and healthy, because I've never struggled like that. I've done trails like this plenty of times on much hotter days than today. Today wasn't even that bad, to be honest. Probably was still in the 90s and there was a breeze the whole time. But holy crap, that killed me. I was really questioning it at a few points, even coming back down. That sun was brutal, very exposed. So let that be a lesson to you. A guy that thought he was experienced and had it down, didn't quite get to the danger zone, I would say, but probably wasn't too far off today. So yeah, I'm just glad to be back. As always, if you enjoyed this video, please like, share, and subscribe, and find us on social media at Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. Dude, I think it's time to fire up the Kenny Loggins for the ride home, danger zone style. Because I was on the highway to the danger zone back there, I think. Woo doggy.